I'm Lindsay Alexander, and this is MyBankTracker.com. Buying a home is such an important financial investment that will happen in your life. You want to make sure how the home will feel now, tomorrow, and even 10 years down the road. You'll be putting thousands of future dollars into mortgage payments, and you don't want to be in over your head when it comes to that point. Your future is important, and you should be wise as to going about making such a huge purchase. Now, there are mistakes that many people make when buying a home. I'm going to give you some advice and tell you what to do and how you can avoid them. Location will always be the most important factor to consider. The location of your home includes far more than the value of real estate. Now, you may be comfortable in your current state with the location of the home, but you have to factor in how your family can evolve. What school district does the home fall in? How far are the highways, and is there good public transportation? Try to find out everything that may be relevant to that location before buying your new home. You may like to live close to parks, but frequent events at the park may cause heavy traffic near your home. See if your home could be in a flood zone. You have to consider these factors because you don't want to end up finding all this out later and you're stuck in an unhappy environment. A good idea to consider is speaking to neighbors and people in town to find out daily affairs and all the quirks that come along with living there. Then there is the right house to buy and to sell. As with any investment, you have to keep in mind how much value you'll be getting out of the purchase. With a house, you have to keep in mind the future, like the resale value, especially if you don't plan on living there long term. Do your best to figure out the most realistic time frame of how long you plan on owning this home, because the shorter amount of time you stay in your home, the harder it will be to sell. The quicker you try to sell, the less equity you have built in your house, especially without a large down payment. Living in your home allows you to build more equity and lets the property increase in value. However, if you're buying an old house, you will need to do some remodeling. If you don't, the house will hardly fetch more than what you spent because the kitchens and bathrooms are now twice as old. Another important factor is making sure your finances are in order. Your credit score is just as important, if not more, than your actual budget because it will determine the rate you will pay on your mortgage. A better score could mean thousands of dollars less in payments over the life of your mortgage. As you may know, your credit score is super sensitive to credit card purchases, closing or opening credit cards and other loans. For that reason, do not buy anything on credit. Yes, that means with your credit card. Once you have completed the loan application and until you have closed the sale, then it's safe to do so. But avoid all costs, the purchase of any new automobiles, heavy appliances like washers, dryers, refrigerators, lawnmowers and other outdoor equipment, even computers and big pieces of furniture. Slight alterations in your credit ratio could cause your score to change and an underwriter will deny your loan. Finding the budget is also a major factor. Yes, the housing crisis and probably the entire dismal state of our economy came about because of people buying houses out of their reach. Just because you can afford the mortgage doesn't mean you can afford the home. Aside from energy, water, heat, and other periodic maintenance fees on the home, you also have to factor expenses like private mortgage insurance, annual property taxes, homeowners insurance, and repairs and upkeep. Consider finding a home that you can afford and pay it down in 15 or 20 years. This will put you in a much better position in buying and in building equity on the home in case you want to sell it in the future. If you can, don't lock yourself into owning just half the home in 15 years when you could have otherwise owned a different one in full. I'm Lindsay Alexander with MyBankTracker.com, and together we're going to build your finances and rebuild the world.